For the past decade, the University of Ottawa Heart Institute has been Dr. Robert Roberts's second home.
The Institute has been a most inspiring place. I would do all 10 years over again.
A pioneer in genetic molecular cardiology, Dr. Roberts spent 30 years in the U.S. before coming to Ottawa. He was recruited from the Baylor College of Medicine in Houston.
Part of my mandate given by the team that had recruited me was to try and establish a more national and international reputation for the Institute.
Dr. Roberts founded the Ruddy Canadian Cardiovascular Genetics Center.
It was truly one of the most successful things I've ever done, period.
Which has conducted large-scale studies in search of the genes responsible for coronary artery disease.
There are now about 50 genes that have been confirmed for heart disease, and the Institute and the Genetic Center have co-authored over two-thirds of them. And so it's truly been a big part of our international reputation.
Dr. Roberts had the vision to pursue large-scale genome-wide association studies. And really, this couldn't have happened without his input and his energy, because he was really the driving force behind these discoveries.
Patient care has also improved under his leadership. Dr. Roberts has helped cut wait times for elective procedures from 4 to 6 months down to a matter of weeks.
And that meant building labs and convincing the government to do so. And in fact, we've probably have built more than a dozen labs.
Patients like Charles Hall are grateful. He went to see his doctor after noticing tightness in his chest. He says an angiogram was scheduled in no time.
It decreases worry, and it just makes life easier and better, and you can get on with your life. I've been so early, I haven't had a heart attack or anything. The heart's not damaged, so it's my recovery should be fairly quick.
As for Dr. Roberts' greatest legacy?
I think that would be developing a sustained funding for research. We have tripled our endowment from about $15 million to $54 million dedicated to cardiovascular research. And that's what put us in the top 2% in the world.
And don't forget about funding for the new building, which will increase the capacity of the Institute by 50%.
Good to see you. You're keeping the place clean, I think.
From the people to the place itself, no detail has been too small for Dr. Roberts.
I feel very proud for the Institute, and I'm delighted to have had the opportunity to be in charge of such a wonderful group of people.
At 73 years old, Dr. Roberts will step down as president and CEO of the Heart Institute on March 31st. But don't expect him to call it a career just yet.
I don't feel I have any less energy today than I had 10 years ago. I'm ready to, probably with greater experience, to take on some new challenge.